Good morning to one and all. How are you, children? In the previous class, you have learned tenses. Under present tense, we have already completed three forms of it. That is simple present or present indefinite. Secondly, it was present continuous tense. And thirdly, and the last lesson, we have learned about present perfect tense. I hope you all understood what is present perfect tense. Okay, anyhow, I just wanted to review the present perfect tense. We use present perfect tense to talk about the completed actions in the present. As we have discussed, completed actions are of two types. One is the completed actions in the past, the other, the completed actions in present time. Okay, the presently completed actions are considered present perfect tense, isn't it? I have done my work. Today I have really completed all my work. I have completed in the sense you recently completed something. I have done up. I did my work. I have met my friend means you have not. I have met my friend in a sense, currently you met your friend. So all these things you can express using the right structure, that is subject plus have or has plus V3 plus object. Okay, and today's lesson and today's topic of tense is present perfect continuous tense. What is that? Present perfect continuous tense. What is present perfect continuous tense and when do we use it? What are the uses of present perfect continuous tense? What is the structure? How can we form present perfect continuous tenses? Okay, and how it can be structured? Let's learn. We use present perfect continuous tense in order to talk about an action that started happening in present and it keeps going over a period of time in present time. Once again, okay, an action that starts in the present time and it keeps going over a period of time in present. What does it mean by started an action? Some action that began in present time and it keeps continuing over a period of time until it gets ended. Have you understood? You can't understand if I say like this, okay, unless I show you the structure of present perfect continuous tense, you cannot understand what I mean to say about present perfect continuous tense. As we all know present continuous tense, what is present continuous tense? Let us compare with present continuous to present perfect continuous tense. But first of all, let me give you a kind of idea regarding present perfect continuous tense. Okay, an action that started. He has been reading the novel since a month. He has been reading a novel since a month. Okay, it means he started somewhere in present and it keeps going till now. Okay? It has been raining since morning. When it started in the morning and till late evening, it keeps raining. How do you say it has been raining? Don't say it's raining. It has been raining. Why do you say it has been raining? It started in the morning. It has been raining since morning. When it started? In the morning it started. In the morning in the sense, is it today or yesterday? Today. So you are talking about present time. In present time, certain action is started and it keeps going and it keeps happening over a period of time. Have you understood? My children have been watching the cartoon since an hour. My children have been watching cartoon since 1 hour. When they started? 1 hour before. An hour before they started. And while they have been watching, It's taken 1 hour. Since 1 hour, my kids have been watching cartoon. Got it? Okay. And one more example. The team of players or the team of players have been playing football since afternoon. When they started? They started in the afternoon. When they ended up? They have been shooting a movie since 1 year. They have been shooting that movie since 1 year. When they started? 1 year before they started. And it has been 1 year. Okay, they have been shooting the movie, okay, since 1 year. Is it understood? At one point of time, they have started doing something and it keeps going over a period of time and present tense. Okay, let's move on with present perfect continuous tense structure. What's the structure of present perfect continuous tense? You know, subject plus have or has plus been plus V1 plus ing plus object. Once again, subject plus have or has plus been plus V1 plus ing. What is the other name for V1 plus ing? We call it as V4. In English, we call V4 a verbal form as participle. What do we call it? Participle. And V1 is simple present or simple present tense. And ing is the gerund form. V1 plus ing is nothing but V4 or the present participle. What do we call it? V4 is nothing but present participle. So when we are using present perfect continuous tense, we use this structure. As I discussed in the previous class, have goes with I, we, you, they, and has is the primary auxiliary that goes with the third person singular, that's he, she, and it. Okay, have goes with I, we, you, they, has goes with he, she, it, plus been plus ing. What is been? Could you please guess? Be is one of the forms of be form, primary auxiliary. Been is one of the forms of be, primary auxiliary. Okay, as I discussed with you, be, is, am, are, or used in present tense. And been plus V4 is used for present perfect continuous tense. Okay, present perfect continuous tense, we use been. Been is the third form of be. Be was been. Is was been. Am was been. Are were been. This is called be form. How many primary auxiliaries we discussed last time? There are three primary auxiliaries. Be auxiliaries, do auxiliaries, and have auxiliaries. Do auxiliaries or do and does in present tense. Have auxiliaries or have and has in present tense. And be auxiliaries or be, is, am, and are. But been is used to talk about the past participle of be. That is used whenever we are using have or has. Have or has always goes with V3. Isn't it? That V3 form we always use it. She has been doing. She has been running. Okay? You went to a park and you started playing or you started running, you started walking on the trails and you have been walking since an hour. Okay? The water is boiling. The water has been boiling since 30 minutes. Okay? At one particular time it has been happening. Okay, in present perfect continuous tense, an action that starts somewhere in present and it keeps going over a period of time in present, and it also gets ended or it would be ended up at one particular point of time. Okay, so she has been writing her notes. She has been listening to songs from morning. okay? My mother started, she has been cooking many dishes since 1 hour. When she started her cooking, 1 hour before she started, she has taken completely 1 hour of time to do those dishes, for preparing those dishes. My mother has been cooking. My mother has been cooking. My driver has been picking up the things from the market. You sent your driver to market to pick some vegetables for you. He has been doing marketing. He has been doing marketing. So what does it mean by an action that began at one point of time in present and it keeps going over a period of time? I hope you all understand what is present perfect continuous tense. What is the structure? Subject plus have or has plus been plus V1 plus ing plus object. Once again, subject plus have or has plus been plus V4 or V1 plus ing plus object. When do we use it? We used to talk about any action that starts in the present and it keeps moving or going over a period of time in present, and it also would be ended up in present. Have you understood, children? And whenever you are learning tenses, you need to do extensive work. Like you have to practice. Unless you practice, you never pick up the speed of doing this. Okay, learning tenses is not very difficult, because when you focus at the topic or when you focus at the content, you will be picking up the speed and you can also getting better in understanding. Just listening to this or watching this video will not give you okay complete idea of this. Repeatedly you need to listen to me, or repeatedly you have to play this YouTube video, so that you'll be getting an idea how it can be used. Here in present perfect continuous tense, we are using the time factor, like since, from, morning, okay, at one point of time to till now, whatever it is happening, we are using the since or from. Okay, these are all the time adverbs. Okay, adverb of time should be used whenever you are quoting the examples. Okay, and until we meet in the next class, goodbye, take care.